Greetings and welcome. What I want to show today is a new feature in release 7.4 of the Secure Firewall from Cisco. And this is the Encrypted Visibility Engine ability to block malicious files, and plus a couple other changes I want to just note with that engine. So what I'm going to show here first is, here we are in the FMC, the Firewall Management Center, and I'm here in Policies. So I'm in Policies, Access Control. So that's where you're going to control the Encrypted Visibility Engine behavior. So I'm going to edit the policy I have here. Pretty simple policy. I think I only have one rule in it. But the settings are here in the advanced settings of the policy. So go to advanced. Then down on the right, you have the Encrypted Visibility Engine. Now in the past, all you did was turn this on with just one switch. There's a couple more configurations here now. So if I look at the configuration here, so there are three sections to this dialog. There's the About section, the Recommended settings, and of course the settings themselves at the bottom. So the About is just about Eve. You can click the Learn More link there to learn more about it. Recommended settings. So before you get going, make sure that you update your vulnerability database update and keep it updated. So here we have a way to quickly go and schedule those updates. Now you may already have that scheduled, which is great. But it becomes more important with Eve because Eve gets its fingerprints from the VDB. So those VDB releases are actually coming more frequently now, so updating those is more important if you're using Eve than even if it is just for the host database. Then enable success network. That allows us to get telemetry from your devices into your FMC to understand how the Eve fingerprints are working, and so we can tune those and make sure that avoid false positives and make sure everything works better. Okay, so to enable Eve, you just flip the switch here. Now when you turn it on, now you'll see there's three controls here. The one at the top, of course, turns it off and on. Then below that you have the Use E for Application Detection. Now this is on by default, and it's been the Eve default behavior up to this point. We just give you an option here to turn that off if you want to. So basically, if you uncheck that, then Eve will not update the client application with the information from the client hello fingerprint. Now most of the time you're going to want that to happen, but this allows you to turn that off if you just don't want that application information updated for some reason. But the most exciting switch here is the one to block traffic based on the Eve score. So when you check that or flip that over, that will enable now process traffic going through this access control policy will be blocked if the Eve score is above a certain threshold. The default out of the box here is a very high threshold, and that's a score basically from 0 to 100. If you want to see what that score is, you can flip the advanced knob here button, and then you'll see that it's 99 out of the box. And you can move that up and down here by just moving the slider, or you can actually type a number in here if you want to. And my recommendation, probably just stick with the default, which is very high. Let it go from there. If you feel like you need to turn it down, go ahead, but beware. False positives could cause application interruption because you're actually blocking the traffic here. So, but you have an option for that. Then it's all that's left is to click OK, then save the changes to the policy and deploy the policy. I'll give that a minute to deploy and be right back with you. So here we are at the Unified Events Viewer, the UEV, Unified Events Viewer, we call it. And this has various columns you can configure. Now I've saved a column set specific to Eve events. And so I want to have things like the encrypted visibility process score column, confidence score, process name, etc., detection type. Now you can change those columns over here with the column selector. Now that's moved over, you notice, from the left side to the right side of the screen in 7.4, if you've seen that before. So just move from left to right. Otherwise it's pretty much the same. But you can save these column sets. Don't forget this. I think this feature's already been in there, but I'll just run over real quick. So I save this as a column set called Eve Set. So once you configure your columns, you can put a name in here, save it. If you want to update these, say if I want to update my column sets, I can do things like rename, delete, or overwrite it with a new column set here. But that's a pretty handy way to save those column sets and come back in if you have a certain type of view you want to see. So anyway, I'm looking at the Eve events here. And so you can see there's some encrypted visibility in the detection type. Detection type, if you recall, that's what determines how this client application is set, right? So the client application is going to get set either by app ID, by looking at the traffic kind of in clear text, or by the encrypted visibility engine. This detection type column tells you what set that application in the client application column. Now, to see, so we have some encrypted visibility applications here. I think if I scroll down a little bit here, let's move over left so we can see what the action is here. So we've got much of allows here. Okay, that's great. Terribly exciting. So let's go see if we have any blocks. So let's go ahead and exclude allows from our filter. So I don't want to see allowed actions. I want to see anything that's not allowed, right? Okay, so you can see we have some alert actions from intrusion events we've had over the period of time here. But now also down here we have these encrypted visibility blocks. So this is the new event type you're going to get now with the encrypted visibility engine. And if we scroll over to the right here, let's take that second to the bottom event here. You can see we have the process confidence score, the visibility threat confidence score, and the process name. And you can see the threat confidence score there, 100% sure that's malware. The visibility process name there is malware. Now, this is actually a test I ran that we're using the OpenSSL command. It sends specific client hellos that are designed actually kind of like the ICAR test file. You have a test you can send through and it'll identify it as malware. If it was real malware, this malware column would be much more descriptive. It actually tells you the malware family, not just, hey, it's malware. It actually gives you the malware family, gives you more information about what might be going on. So the point here is, hey, we got some malware on a host. Sure, we blocked it. But honestly, we really should be going back and checking this host right here, right, and saying, hey, looks like you got some malware stuff running on you. This is bad. We should probably clean that up. Another new E feature I want to demonstrate is the ability to see the fingerprint and to provide feedback. So I'm going to reset my view here. I'm just going to change this so I can see all the events again. Okay, so I'm going to filter these so I can see just processes where the confidence score is high, maybe where the detection type is encrypted visibility. So let's do that. We'll change this to inclusion. So maybe you find some fingerprints that are triggering and they're being identified as a certain application, but it's a false positive, or maybe it's an incorrect application that's being identified. So in this case here we have Chromium, a bunch of Chromiums here, right? And the confidence score is 99% on those, and so the detection type is encrypted visibility is changed in the client application to Chrome. So if you happen to know this is a different type of connection, you want to provide some feedback and say, hey, you guys need to, you know, tune up this fingerprint a little bit because this actually isn't Chrome, it's, you know, something else. You can come over to the fingerprint columns. This is a column you can add, encrypted visibility fingerprint. Now, you notice these are quick fingerprints. You have TLS and quick, and this illustrates also the fact that encrypted visibility engine can fingerprint quick as well as just regular TLS. So I can click on the quick fingerprint here for Chromium. And you'll find this view encrypted visibility engine process analysis, which takes you out to an external site. That takes you to the appid.cisco.com site, and it plugs in the fingerprint from this process. Now across the top, you can put your information in. And if you're going to provide feedback on a process, which this form is for, I'd highly recommend you add your information in there so the AppID team can contact you for more information if they need it. So down here you can see the quick fingerprint, and then you can see the prevalence, which is basically what this fingerprint is identified as on your system. Now most of the time that fingerprint's going to come out as Chrome, Chromium browser, but a small percentage of the time that fingerprint will be some other process. So you can see that there's metadata around the connection we use as well to identify the processes, not just the fingerprint. So sometimes the fingerprint is a different process based on the metadata, you know, destination, IPs, ports, domains, things like that. So to provide feedback, so you want to provide feedback on the Chromium browser process here, for instance, because that's what it was identified as, you can check the process name, submit a request, and then you can fill in information to say something like, you know, I happen to know that this process was actually, you know, Evernote or something like that. It was some other process. So this is an excellent way to give your feedback to the AppID team and increase the viability and accuracy of our Eve fingerprints. So that's a quick look at the new features in Release 7.4 of the Encrypted Visibility Engine. get out there and do some identification of those encrypted processes. And as always, happy snorting.